So we're going to use water for illustration purposes to show you what goes on with the air here. So basically we have two, quote, normal or room temperature vases of air here.
Right, the atmosphere, okay.
It's the atmosphere. All right. But we also have in two cups here red dyed air, and we also have blue dyed air. One represents warmer, one represents cold air. So what we're going to do, Tom, is we're going to take some of the warm air first. We're going to put it in our syringe here. And we're going to put it in.
I'll step back for this
part. Put your board up there. And what? Ready? Watch what happens here, right? And explain to our viewers what's going on here, Tom.
Well, you see the air mix in here, and this is the warmer air is less dense. And that less dense air is staying where? At the top half of the cylinder, or the top half of this portion of the atmosphere.
Now, if we take our cold air that we have, and this is ice cold water, and we plunge this in, Tom, it should indeed be heavier and go down, more dense, and go down to the bottom, or at least mix down to the bottom, whereas the red didn't.
And it is, indeed. It's going to take some time here, but that cold air mixes down. This is an example of that Arctic front, that Arctic air that worked its way down through the plains and along the front range of the Rockies here over the past 48 hours. So the cold air denser, and it stays down below.
Interesting to see. The blue does go quite a bit farther down there.
But at higher elevations, where the air was actually warmer yesterday, there were no clouds.
It's amazing. And today, Sam and Maria, Aspen, Colorado will be 30 degrees warmer than Denver, Colorado, right, which is about 2,600 feet lower in elevation. It's all because of air density.